Hello everyone, I, Kundan Chandrakar, welcome you all to the SWAM online course lecture on planning for safety. Now coming today lecture, in this video, we will going to learn about the various planning in construction safety. What is site safety plan? A site safety plan is a documented procedure that is designed to cover the hazards with the high chances of occurrence. Safety plan are custom made document that can be amended and changes keeping in view the hazards of the workplace. What are the example of safety plans? Here are just a few example of safety regulation and require written plan like emergency action plan, electrical safety plan, fire prevention plan, hearing conservation plan, hazard communication program, reciprocatory protection program, blood-borne pentagon post-exposure plan, trenching and excavation program. What is a construction safety plan? The construction safety plan, written a safety plan, involve planning, but once it is put together, your team will be have a solid plan should be any emergency will be arise. Simply following an outline or temples can help you speed up the program and process. Here are a few elements that are usually involved in a safety plan. Policy or goal statement, list of responsible person, safety and emergency contact information, descriptive of site condition and location, description of a project slope, hazard identification, hazards control and safe practices, and the last one is after adding this element to your safety plan, incorporate the tips below to help you craft a complete blueprint for keeping your worker and community safe. Let us discuss the main point, allow flexibility and adaptability. Safety plan should be flexible and adaptable so team can use them across multiple projects. Since construction is a dynamic industry with high volatility in terms of hazards and working condition, it is even more crucial to have a safety plan that adapts to every type of projects. For example, a general safety plan usually includes detail of who to contact and what action to take during an accident. On the other hand, in the site-specific safety plan, safety protocol are individualized and catered directly to each specific construction projects. The second main point is a required personal protective equipment. To show client that your company is fully committed to the safety of all employees, make sure to include a list of PPE issued to the each employees in your safety plan. Some example of PPE includes hard hats, earwear, face mask and ear muff. Emphasize that each employee is responsible for and well trained in proper use of care of his and her safety equipment. The third main point is a detailed construction site rules. For instance, a common safety hazards on construction site in smoking in undesignated area. Even through the Occupational Safety and Health Administration has a no regulation that specifically address smoke area on construction site. Ensuring a hazards-free workplace should still be the most priority of all employers. The fourth main point is clarify role of each employee. Every employee plan an important part in the success of safety plan. Therefore, all construction worker and subcontractor should have a clear understanding of their job description and responsibility before they start work. In the safety plan, employers should also document the proper step of action each employee should take in an event of an emergency and ensure that each employee is familiar with their duties. The fifth main point is establishment protocol to mitigate risk. One of the main purpose of a safety plan is to demonstrate the company protocol for risk management and workplace safety. Employers should include guidelines and protocol in their plan, such as an operating procedure for heavy equipment and excavation safety measure to avoid accidents. When risk become a reality, not only can construction project become delayed, but employees can suffer from detrimental injuries. To avoid this disaster, make sure to implement safety protocol across all sites. The sixth main point is take weather condition into account. Since the majority of construction projects are outdoor, weather conditions are another element to take into account when creating your plan. Since the weather can not be controlled or manipulated, ensure that each construction site has a preparedness plan for hazardous weather condition. For serve cold and extreme heat. Start by evaluating site-specific risk in the case of serve weather event, then customize your safety plan according to type of extreme weather you may encounter in your area. The seventh point is a list emergency contact information. This point is also be important. When a well-designed construction safety plan, ensure that all personnel on site can take quickly and effective action to resolve any emergency. One of the best way to reduce emergency response time is designating one or more emergency contact person in the safety plan. This list of emergency contact should include both internal and external contact. Not only site supervisor and property manager, but also emergency support service such as fire department, paramedical and the police. Let us discuss safety management system. Why safety management system is important? In recent year, a great deal of effort has been devoted to understanding how accident happen in aviation, for example, and other industry. It is now generally accepted that most accident result are human error. It would be easy to conclude that this human error indicate carelessness or incompetence on the job, but that would not accurate. Investigators are finding that the human is only the last link in a chain that lead to an accident. We will not prevent accidents by changing people. We will only prevent accident when we address the underlying cause and factor. A safety management system is a business-like approach to safety. It is a systematic, explicit, and comprehensive process for managing safety risk. As with all management system, a safety management system provides for a goal setting, planning, and measuring performance. A safety management system is woven into a fabric of an organization. It becomes parts of culture that way people do their job. Let us discuss the four major points for safety management system. Philosophy: safety management system start with management. The main points are philosophy that will be donated to recognize that there will always be a threat to safety. The second main point is setting the organization standards. And the third main point is confirming that safety is everyone's responsibility. The second point is a policy. Specific how safety will be achieved, clear statement of responsibility, authority, and accountability, development of organization process and structure to incorporate safety goal into every aspect of the operational and development of the skills and knowledge necessary to their job. The third main point is a procedure. What safety management want people to do? Excavate the policy. Clear direction to the all staff. Means of planning, organization and controlling. And means of monitoring, assessing safety status and processes. The last fourth main point is a practice. What really happened on the job? Following well-designed, effective production, avoiding the shortcut that can be distract from safety, and taking appropriate action when the safety concern is identified. Let us discuss the problems in construction sites. Unexpected release of toxic reaction and flammable liquid and gases in process involve highly hazardous chemical have been reported for many years. Incident continue to occur in various industry that use highly hazardous chemical which may be toxic, reactive and flammable or explosive. The combination of these properties regardless of the industry that uses this highly hazardous chemical, there is a potential of an accident release of any time they are not properly controlled and they turn create a possibility of hazards. Although this major disaster involved highly hazardous chemical drew national attention to the potential for major accidents, the public record is replating with information concerning many other less notable release of highly hazardous chemical. Hazardous chemical release continuity to pose significant threat to employees and provide impetus internationally and nationally authority to develop or consider developing legislation and regulation to eliminate or minimize the potential for such event. How the standards work? The standards mainly apply to manufacturing industry, particularly those pertaining to chemical, transportation equipment and fabrication metal product. Other affected sector including natural gases liquid, farm product warehousing, electrical, gas and sanitary service and the wholesale trades. It is also apply the pyrotechnic and explosive manufacturing covered under the OSHA regulation and the special provision for contractor working in covered facilities. Let us discuss process safety information. Employer must complete a compilation of writing process safety information before conducting any process hazard analysis. Required by the standard, the compilation of written process safety information completed under the SAFE schedule. Required the process hazard analysis will help the employer and the employees involved in operating the process to identify and understand the hazard process. Those processing involving highly hazardous chemical process safety information must be needed. Information on the hazards of a highly hazardous chemical used or produced by the processes. Information on the technology for the process and information of the equipment is the process. So let us discuss information on hazards of the highly hazardous chemical in the process cell consist of at least the following. The first one is a toxicity, permissible exposure limit, physical data, reactivity data, corrosivity data and thermal and chemical stability data and hazardous effect in advertising mixing of a different material. Information on the technology for the process must include at least the following. A block flow diagram or specified process flow diagram. Process chemistry, maximum intended inventory, safe upper and lower limit for such as item like temperature, pressure, flow and composition contents. And valuation of the consequence of derivation, including those affected, the safety and health for employees. Let us discuss information on the equipment in process must include the following. Materials of construction, piping and instrument diagram, electrical classification, relief system design and design basis, ventilation system design, design code and standard employed, material and energy balance for processes built after may, after systematic. Safety system, example, interlock, detection or suspension system. Let us discuss process hazard analysis. The process hazard analysis is a thorough, orderly, systematic approach for identifying, evaluating and controlling the hazard of a process involving high hazards chemical. The employer must perform and initiate process hazard analysis on the all process covered by the standard. The process hazard analysis methodology selection must be appropriate to the complexity of the process and must identify, evaluate and control the hazards involved in the process. The employer must use one of the most following methods as appropriate to determine, evaluate the hazards process begin analyzed. The first one is a what if, second checklist, third one is a what if checklist, fourth hazards and operability study, that is HAZOP, and the other one is a failure mode and effect analysis, that will be called FMEA, and the next fault tree analysis, and the last one an appropriate equivalent methodology. The employer must determine whether each employee operating a process has received or understood the training requirement by PSM. A record must be kept contain the identifying of the employees, the date of training, and how to employer verify that the employee understood the training. Let us discuss employer responsibility. When selecting a contractor, the employer must obtain and evaluate the information regarding the contractor, employer, safety performance and program. The employer also must inform contractor to employer of the no potential fire, explosion and toxic release hazards. The contractor work for the process, explain the contractor, employer the applicable provision of the emergency action plan, develop and implement safe work practice to control the presence and entrance and exit of the contact. The contract employees in covered process area evaluate periodically the performance of the contract employer in fulfill their obligation and maintain a contract employee injury and illness log related to the contractor work in the process area. Let us discuss contract employer responsibility. The contract employer must ensure that contract employees are trained in the work practice necessary to perform their job safely. Ensure that contract employees are instructed in the no potential fire, explosion and toxic hazards related to their job and process, and in the applicable provision of the emergency action plan. Document the each contract employees has received and understood the training required by the standard by preparing a record that contained identify the contract employees and the date of training and means used of verify the employees understood the training. Ensure that each contract employees follow the safety rule of the facility include the required safe work practice, required the operating procedure section of the standard. Advise the employer of the any unique hazards presented by the contract employer work. Let us discuss mechanical integrity. OSHA believes it is important to maintain the mechanical integrity of critical process equipment to ensure it designed and installed correctly and operate properly. PSM mechanical integrity requirements apply to the following equipment: pressure vessel and storage tank. The main points are followed: piping system, relief and vent system and devices, emergency shutdown system, control including monitor device, sensor, alarms and interlock, and the last one is a pump. The employer must establishment and implement written procedure to maintain the ongoing integrity of process equipment. The employees involved in maintaining the ongoing integrity of process equipment must be trained in a overview of the process and it is hazards and trained the procedure applicable to the employee's job task. Let us discuss greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases are another category of air contamination. They are grouped specifically because of their potential role in global warming. Greenhouse gases trap the heat coming from the Earth's surface in atmosphere and contribute to global warming. The main greenhouse gases are water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, fluorocarbon and ozone. Let us discuss indoor air pollution. Air pollution can occur both outdoor and indoor. Air pollution of concern includes like mold, volatile organic compound, indoor ozone, radon, asbestos, environmental tobacco smoke. With this, we will end our today's lecture. Here, thank you for your patience. We will meet in our next lecture. Thank you.